Hi everyone, and welcome to today's Yoga Flow for Shoulder Mobility. We hold a lot of tension in our shoulders. We often round the upper back and are just tense in this area. So today's class is designed to create strength in the shoulders and to stretch the shoulders in ways that you normally don't stretch it. Every body is different, so make sure to be gentle to your body. If you feel any pain in any of the poses, make sure to modify it or just rest in child's pose and try it maybe again in a couple of days or weeks when your shoulders feel more open. I recommend you have a block close by, which we will use during the class. So let's get started in a seated position on the mat, and we come into child's pose right away. So spread your knees out wide, your big toes are together to touch, and then walk your hands forward to a child's pose. You can lower your head down on the mat or on a block or bolster if this feels better for you. And we start right away with a shoulder stretch. To stretch the shoulders in this pose, bring your forearms up and bring them to a prayer over your head. And then actively walk your elbows forward a little bit. Maybe a little more. Yes. And then relax into this pose and feel this nice stretch in your shoulders. And close your eyes and find your breath. Just notice your breath flowing in and out. Maybe walk your elbows forward a little more to open the shoulders more. And concentrate on your breath. Then slowly bring your hands down. Bring your booty up and come to a tabletop position. And we start with a really nice warm up for the shoulders. So come to your tabletop pose first, then bring the left hand up to your left shoulder. And we start with a simple shoulder opening pose. So first your elbow is down, and with your inhale, reach your elbow up as high as you can. Four more. Inhale, reach up, exhale down. Move slowly and with control. And try to bring your elbow up as high as you can. Last one, reach the elbow up high, stay here. Then extend your arm up to the ceiling. And we start to make big circles with the arms. Four, five, four, three, two, one. Last one, and bring your hand back down. We do the same on the other side. Right hand comes to right shoulder, elbow comes down first. Inhale, reach the elbow up, exhale down. Four more. Last one, reach the elbow up as high as you can. Then extend your hand up to the ceiling and draw big circles to the back. One, two, three, four, five. And let's do one more as we did on the other side. And bring your hands back down on the mat. Stay in your tabletop pose. And we will come into cat and cow stretches right away. But today I want you to focus on the shoulder areas. So with your inhale, bring the shoulder blades together, really squeeze them together as much as you can. And with your exhale, press into your hands and broaden your shoulders so that there is so much space between your shoulder blades. Four more. Inhale and exhale. Yeah. One more. Bring the shoulder blades together first. Then press into your hands and spread the shoulder blades apart. Awesome. Then come back to a neutral spine and sit back on your heels so that you are in a kneeling position. Bring your hands onto your knees and we start with a really simple exercise. So first, let your shoulders just hang naturally. And with your inhale, roll your shoulders back and down your spine. Let's do this four more times. So your elbows hang forward, a little bit like you normally sit. Inhale and correct your posture. Roll the shoulders up and back. Three more. This should feel really good. Last time, roll the shoulders open, open up your heart. Stay here in this pose. For the next exercise, I like to bring my hand either on my belly or on my upper left chest. Then cactus out the left arm. Make a fist with your left hand so your left elbow should be in line with your left shoulder and it should stay there all the time. Your palm is facing forward but in a fist, and then slowly turn your fist facing down and turn it back up. Try to keep your elbow as stable as possible, so it should stay where it is. It's really, really hard. Move slowly. We do this five times. Bring all your attention to your shoulder, to your elbow. Last one. Bring your fist down and back up, and we switch sides. Left hand comes onto the right chest. Cactus out the right arm. Make a fist. Fist shows to the front. Elbow is in line with the shoulder, and then slowly bring your fist down. Inhale up. Exhale down. This side is a little bit more tricky for me. Maybe it's the same for you. I really also feel a little cracking here. So remember, if you feel any pain, don't do this exercise. It should be a challenge, but you should not feel any pain. One more. And bring your fist back up. And relax your hands down on your knees for a moment. Let's take a deep breath in and out here. And we come forward, laying down on the belly. Bring your forearms down on the mat first. And we come into my favorite yoga pose to strengthen the shoulders, which is dolphin pose. So dolphin pose is almost the same as downward facing dog. We just have our forearms down on the mat. So bring your forearms down on the mat. They should be parallel to each other. Your hands should be spread apart. Then tuck your toes. Lift your body up and then walk your toes forward as far as you can and come to this dolphin pose. As I say, same as downward facing dog, just with your forearms down. And this is a really great pose to open and to strengthen the shoulders. We will stay here for three more breaths. Pull the belly button in. And reach your sitting bones up high. Your heels don't need to touch the mat here. One more deep breath. And then if you're able to, press up into a downward facing dog or come to a downward facing dog, lowering your knees down first. Walk your hands to the front of the mat. Interlace your hands behind your back and stretch your palms up to the ceiling for this forward bend with a nice shoulder stretch. This should feel really yummy now. Let your head hang heavy and relax here. Your knees can be gently bent. Your neck and your face are completely relaxed. Then release your hands, bring them back down on the mat and step back first to a downward facing dog, then come to a plank pose and lower back down onto your belly. We will do a couple of exercises now on the belly. You can, for the first one, have a block at the top left edge of your mat and then lay down on your belly, make a pillow with your right hand and lower your head and your cheek down on this. Then extend your left arm out to the side so it's on the outside of the block and your thumb should show up. So we are in this Y shape. And for the first exercise, we will simply lift up the thumb and bring it to the other side of the block. Let's do this 5 times in total. This is really great to strengthen the shoulder here. So now I forgot to count. We will do one more on each side. Great. Then keep your hand as it is with thumb up, but we come to a more W shape with the arm, so your elbow is in line with your shoulder and your elbow stays on the mat, and then lift up your thumb and your wrist a little bit and bring it back down. 4 more. Lift up. 1 more. Great. So, 1 more exercise in this pose. This time bring your fist down on the mat. Your thumb does not need to show up anymore. Your elbow stays in line with your shoulder and your wrist is also in line with your shoulder. And for this exercise, we lift the fist up a little bit. Bring it to the front so that your forearm is parallel to the mat. Extend the arm to the front. Bring it back, lower the wrist down, and come back to the mat. 4 more. Lift the wrist up, make it parallel to the front, back, and come down. 3 more. Lift up to the front, extend, bend, bring the fist back down. Last one. Awesome. Let's do the same on the other side. So bring your block over to the right side first. Then make a little pillow with your left hand. Extend your right arm out to the side, to the outside of the block. And we bring the thumb over the block 5 times on each side. For 1, for 2, for 3, keep your arm extended. For 4, and for 5. Great job. Then bring your arm to this W form. Your elbow stays on the mat and we'll lift the fist up for 5. For 4, for 3, for 2, and for 1. Then bring the fist on the mat so that it's in line with your shoulders and with your elbow. Lift the wrist up, bring it to the front, extend the arm, bend the arm, bring the fist down. 4 more.
Last one. Bring the wrist up. Extend it to the front. Bend back. And bring the fists back down. Great.
Let's do another exercise in this laying down position. So we will come to this W shape again. Build fists with your wrists. With your inhale, you lift the torso, the head up, and then extend your fists to the front, bring it back, and lower back down. Four more. Lift up, extend to the front, bend,
come back down. To protect your lower back here, make sure that you activate your thighs and also your glutes when you do this exercise. So activate them.
Then lift up, extend to the front, bend and back down.
Two more.
Inhale, extend and come down.
Last one.
Lift up, extend, bend
and come down. Awesome job, everyone. We end
this group of exercise with a really nice shoulder stretch. For that, extend your left arm out. And then peel the right side of your body off the mat and bring your right leg as close to the left hand as possible. That sounds crazy, but I'll show it for a moment. It's called scorpion stretch. So bring the right foot as close to the left hand as possible, and you should feel a really nice opening in your shoulder here. You can use your right hand to support this stretch. Great. And just do the best that you can here. Doesn't need to look like it looks on the screen for you now. Just step your right foot over your left leg. And the most important thing is that you feel this nice stretch in your left shoulder. Then slowly come back to center. Same on the other side. Extend your right arm out to the side. Peel the left side up and roll over, bring the left foot as close to the right hand as possible. Close your eyes and enjoy this opening of the shoulders. And come back to center. And come sitting up. We continue our stretching of the shoulders. The next pose is a reverse table. So we did a normal table first. Now we reverse the table. So sit back down on your mat first. Bring the hands down behind you so that your fingers point to the front of the mat. Your feet should be down on the mat, hip width apart, and then lift your hips up as high as you can. And you should feel an immediate stretch in your shoulders. You can either let your head hang heavy or keep it up high, whatever feels better. And then what I like to do is to move back and forth here a little bit to really open the shoulders. Awesome. So it's not so important to keep your hips up as high as you can. I encourage you to do that, but the important thing is that you feel an opening and a stretch in your shoulders here. And then bring your hips back down, bring the soles of your feet together in front of you. We will come to a butterfly stretch, but with a shoulder stretch. So soles of the feet are together, your knees are out to the side, and then slide your arms under your legs, bring them up to the front as far as you can, and with your legs, you press down your arms a little bit, let your head hang heavy, and the weight of your legs opens up your shoulders here in a really yummy and enjoyable way. So let your head hang heavy. It's time to relax now. And enjoy this opening of the shoulder blades. slowly come back up. And we come to our final resting pose. Lay down on your back. Bring your feet to the outer edges of the mat and let them fall to the sides. Bring your shoulders away from the ears. Make your neck long. Your arms are away from your body, palms facing up. Let's take one more deep breath together. Inhale through your nose. And exhale through your mouth. Shavasana. Bring movement back into your toes and your fingertips. Start to rotate at your wrists and your ankles. Stretch your arms over your head for a full body stretch. Then roll to one side first and come up to a seated position on your mat. Cross your legs in front of you. Bring your hands to a prayer in front of your heart. Thanks for showing up today. Namaste.